So you've opened up FL Studio for the first time, and there's a lot going on in this interface. So we're now going to take a look at the five main interface elements in FL Studio. And once we understand that, it'll be a lot easier to get going and making some music. The five main interface elements we're going to take a look at here are the channel rack, the piano roll editor, the mixer, the playlist, and the browser.
So this is FL Studio. Let's start off by taking a look at the five main windows we will have to get familiarized with in order to use the program to its best capabilities. So to access the five main windows, we can click on any of these five icons here. And if you keep an eye on the hint panel over here, as you hover your cursor on the icons, it will tell you what each icon is. So this one is the playlist, this one is the piano roll, this one is the channel rack, the mixer, and lastly, the browser slash plugin picker. All right, so let's start with the playlist. If I click over here, the playlist window opens. So this is where you will create your musical arrangement. It can house MIDI patterns, audio recordings, automation, anything that is related to your musical arrangement. On the left over here, we have the pattern picker. Patterns are very important in FL Studio. Everything revolves around patterns. You can see over here by default, we already have a pattern pre-selected. We will talk about this more in upcoming videos, but let's move along. So I'll close the playlist. Let's take a look at the second window. This is a piano roll. So here you can create any MIDI parts. So if you want to create a MIDI chord progression, a bass line, a melodic idea, or even a drum pattern, you can use the piano roll. As long as an instrument uses MIDI, you can use the piano roll to sequence patterns for that instrument. All right, so let's close out the piano roll editor. Next, we have the channel rack. This is where we house all the different sound generators for a project. So you can see here in this default project, I already have four sounds. I can even preview them by holding down Command on a Mac or Control on a PC and clicking over here. As you build on your project, your channel rack is going to get larger depending on the different instruments and sound generators you add on. You can see here there's a little plus button. If I click that, we can see all the available sound generators we can add on from here. All right, so that's the channel rack. Next, we have the mixer. As the name suggests, the mixer can be used to balance the individual elements of your arrangement. So we have sliders over here to adjust the levels of individual parts. We have knobs here to adjust the panning. And if we select a particular mixer insert, on the right here, we get 10 effect slots. So we can use any of these different effects to be applied to that particular mixer insert. All right, let's close out the mixer. And then lastly, we have the browser slash plugin picker. So over here, you can access all the different content that you have on your computer. For example, if I click on packs here, these are all the different samples that we get with FL Studio. So going back to the channel rack, as we saw, there were four existing sounds already over here. If I wanted to add on or replace certain sounds, I can do that from the browser. Clicking on an individual audio sample will give us a preview of the sound. All right, so those are the five main windows in FL Studio. The browser slash plugin picker, the mixer, the channel rack, the piano roll editor, and the playlist. Aside from that, we have our main transport over here. So that's the play button, stop button, record button. We have our global tempo here. It's set to 130 by default, but I can click and drag to change the tempo. Over here, we get to choose if the pattern or the song is going to play back. As I mentioned before, patterns are very important in FL Studio. So you can see here, I have pattern number one. So if I select pattern here and hit play, that particular pattern plays back. And you can see nothing is playing back here in the arrangement or the song. If I switch to song mode, now we're playing the song. All right, so that's a quick look at some of the interface elements and the five main windows in FL Studio.